What's up, everybody? Justin here, and it is time to drive. I am bringing you some action from our SCCA Championship Summer Series event number 4 out at Front Range Airport. And I am getting ready to roll here on what would be my second run of the 4-run day. I have a new setup on the car, just had the car realigned, corner balanced, a little bit of a change in the setup to change the handling of the car. It was well balanced and driving good, although a little bit different than how it's been in the past. It's been better. We're going to have a real nice drift coming up here as I'm sliding sideways there through that real fast right-handed sweeper, just bouncing off the rev limiter. But getting through the course here again, getting a little bit sideways, having to correct, didn't quite set myself up through that left-handed sweeper. But car's acting a lot better than it was in the past. I had a little bit of a corner exit push type of situation, or understeer type of situation on corner exits, and I was looking to fix that, and definitely fix that. Car felt better balanced, like I said. I was able to get the rear loose when I needed to, and rotate the car a little bit better when I needed to, so that was a bonus. However, as you saw in that last run there, it was a little bit hard to control, and that was mostly just me getting used to the different car behavior. I'm really liking it overall, and here comes what would be my best time of the day, but turns out I hit two cones. I didn't even know I hit two cones until I looked at the timing and scoring sheet after the event was over. So I thought this was a clean run throughout the run, actually, and felt pretty good for the most part. There were some places I could have gone quicker and made a couple small mistakes. Once again, coming through that left-handed sweeper turn, staying a lot tighter on the cones there, through the quick 1-2 slalom and hard to the right into a really, really long and fast slalom section. As you can hear, I was hitting the rev limiter on quite a few sections of the course, and I'm going to freeze it right here. And after going back through the video, I'm pretty sure this is the cone that I knocked down. As you can see, I'm right on top of the thing. It must have been the one I hit. As I went through the finish box here, I thought I might have knocked it down. As you'll see here in a second, I was actually turning my head back looking at the corner worker, because the corner worker did go out there, but I thought he called it safe. But at any rate, anyways, that was a coned run, didn't count. I didn't know it, however, and going into my fourth run here, I let it all hang out, as you're about to see in a few moments here. Getting ready to go at the starting line and bringing up the data once again. And like I said, I didn't think I had cones on my last run, so I was trying to push real hard on this one to see what I could get out of the car, and unfortunately it didn't work too well. I ended up overcooking a lot of the sections of the course. Well, I guess a couple of the sections of the course. Again, pounding on the rev limiter here, and this is where I made a big mistake and lost a lot of time. Went way too deep in here, had to come way back, get back into the groove, getting myself back into shape for this fast left-hander. Obviously I'm carrying more speed, adding a little more distance. Again, continuing to try to push the car hard. You'll see I'm pushing it real hard through the slalom as I'm sliding around in the transitions left and right, having to make some corrections as the car is sliding. And despite the overcooking of the various sections and turns and not quite putting in the best run, that was my best time for the day, actually, because my previous run was coned out, which I had thought was my fastest time, and this time turned out to be good for 7th overall in the packs, or the index position, so 7th overall out of 157 drivers. Good for 2nd place in the STX class, right behind one of our other very fast and competitive local guys, and I had a good time, so looking forward to getting it back out there. We have more events coming up here in the near future. Hope you all enjoyed the video. Stay tuned for more, and I'll catch you next time.